Hi there. Hey. I'm going to tell you about my experience when I went woofing. Woofing is, and I'm not going to get this exactly right, but it's the Worldwide Organization of Organic Farming, something along those lines. And I had a lot of expectations going in. I'll tell you about what happened, and I'm, despite what happened, it's an interesting story, I guess. I'm still willing to try this again, try something else, and see what happens, see if it's like this at other woofing farms. So, I'm not going to tell you what farm this is, but if you are trying to go to a farm and you either do or don't want this experience, you are welcome to write me at jennacitrus@yahoo.com. I will answer in an email if you really want to know what farm I went to. And this is my first experience. I didn't do this kind of decompress or like share and tell of everything that happened immediately after, so I'm gonna use my journal to sort of help me go through the process of reliving this. I was quite nervous and excited when I left. I spend a lot of time packing. I usually don't pack when I go for trips, pretty much. I just kind of like bring my toiletry bag and like I have a modeling bag, and then I'm like, okay, let's go. But I got my coveralls together. I got several pairs of pants and clothing of various temperatures because I knew I was going to be working outside, at least I sort of thought or assumed or thought, and I thought I was going to go between, like, probably 5 or 6 days. I will give you a spoiler alert, I stayed for 3 hours. I know. one thing I was really excited about on my way down was I've been trying to buy a house for over a year, and I haven't found anything that, like, fits what I want or fits a budget that I sort of am trying to have or, like, anything. I mean, I need probably like $500,000 to buy what I want, which I'm don't have that, so work in progress, right? Hey, click on the ad below. No, just kidding. When I got there, as soon as I drove up, something in me immediately knew it wasn't what I expected, and I'm not sure what I was expecting. I'm not sure what it was that I saw that I was like, whoa, but something didn't feel quite I don't know what I wanted, I guess. What it was a smelly bunch of hippies living in filth. And don't get me wrong, I love hippies, and I will not bathe every once in a while for a couple days, but when you go so long that, like, I was walking about 7 to 10 feet behind this guy as he gave me the tour of the farm, which thank you for the farm tour, but I could still smell his body odor, and it's a bit much. I saw the co-ed dorm space, and it smelled worse than that person did, which made me very nervous. So as I first arrived, there was one woman that had a baby strapped to her, and she was washing the baby's diapers, which I'm like, okay, cool, off-grid living, washing diapers, recycling, reusing, whatever, cool. But then I just kept seeing more and more men. I think there were about 8 or 9 or maybe more of them by the time I'd met everyone on the farm. And it was only after I had decided to leave that I finally saw a few women. And not to be all sexist or anything, but when thinking about sleeping in a co-ed bunkhouse with that many men and how many babies I'd seen there, it got me very nervous. Sure, I was up for the excitement of meeting people in an exciting way, but I was not ready to have babies at all. And a lot of people had babies, which I think all but 2 or 3 of the women I saw had children, which frightened me a lot. Which, I mean, it's cool to be able to, like, bring your kids up in such a, like, an eco-friendly environment, but I'm gonna read my journal a little more here and see where we're going next. When I got home, I was so thankful for this small studio house that I call home. I loved it. I thought it was a mansion. There was running hot water. I mean, I was just above and beyond my wildest expectations of living. I guess there was like tent camping, but there were some structures, but it was just really rough. I don't know. I hate to think that I'm so prissy that I need to have a bath every other day or so, but, like, I love hot running water and the ability to turn the heat on and the air conditioning on, and, yeah, you can call me a spoiled brat, it's okay. So I wasn't ready for off-grid living yet, and I now at least know a little more what to expect if I go back in for another time. I'm not crossing this place off my list and saying I'll never go again, but I know a bit more now. And I know this is going to sound even a little more ridiculous, but all the things I brought with me were so clean. Like, I brought clean sleeping bags and just clean clothes. And how, if I'd gone through my dirty laundry before I left, I might have felt a little better about getting a little more dirty. But, like, I'd showered and I was just like, I was too clean to start with. I think the longest I've gone without a shower was 3 or 4 days. And I was at church camp and we'd had a food fight. And I was so tired that night, and then I didn't get up early enough in the morning. And by the time my mom picked me up, I'd been using hand sanitizer to clean my hair, and it was nasty. And she was like, "You were disgusting." I'm like, "I know, but I'm so happy." And but I'd gotten gradually dirtier. This way, I would have had to just rip off the band-aid and plunge into the filth that is woofing. I told my mom about this, and she was like, "What was that abbreviation again? Was it Wawa or like Wham Wham because you were crying about it?" Yes, that is what it is. So here I am crying about organic farming when I so desperately think I want to do it. I'm gonna have a if I start my own permaculture operation, I'm gonna have a sign that says "Must shower every other day," or "If you're dirty, please don't smell like a hippie." Love you guys. Hippies are great, just don't smell that way. I don't know. Oh, this is so embarrassing to admit all of this, but yeah. Or and then my other thing my mom came up with was offensive body odor for the WOO part, offensiveodor.com. So yeah, I had one stinky experience, and I'm just hopeful that other farms won't be so stinky and I will be able to survive. There are a few that I'm really excited about trying out, although if any of them watch this video, they're never gonna let me come, right? I'm not trashing your guys' farm. I will say that. I will also say there was a library, and I was very excited about it. And as I had a tour, oh, excuse me. Pardon me. The person showing me around said, "Oh wow, this really needs cleaned up," because there were books strewn all over the floor. And after, well, I was trying to go with them to go get something done, and it was just the first hour I was there was like people trying to get organized, and it wasn't going well. And I was like, you know what? I will just go do something else for a little bit. And eventually, I came around to cleaning the library. I did, however, before I cleaned the library, had a really beautiful moment with nature. There was a creek that ran through the property, and it veed. And I sat there on the creek bank, and I played with some moss, and I just watched the water run, and it was a really beautiful moment, and I loved that. So yay for beautiful moments in the, I mean, it wasn't filthy in nature. I mean, I guess that's just what people are like when they roll around in nature that much. There were composting toilets. Someone was currently cleaning them out when I first got there. I didn't have to go to the bathroom, although I realized I went to the bathroom once on my way down, and I did not go to the bathroom the rest of the day until I got home, and I was like, what did I just do here? So I went for like 8 hours without going to the bathroom. Also, when I arrived, I had my black, like knee-length outdoor cold coat on, and I was carrying my purse, and I felt like the most ridiculous person on that farm tour, because I'm like, here I am, a normal member of society, getting a farm tour, and everyone else is wearing what I'll call just like work clothes. And so thankfully I had coveralls that I threw on, and I felt a little more in place. But yeah, I first walked in, I was like, I feel way too prissy for this. And I did get some work done, so I felt good about that. I didn't eat any food, so that was kind of nice, because it's a 4 or 5 hour work exchange for room and board. So I got my tour in, and I worked a bit. And they did have a greenhouse. It was a kind of a dome-ish slash triangle shaped greenhouse, and it was so hot in there. It was in the 50s, so I mean it wasn't freezing or anything, but I went in that greenhouse and I was sweating. That was intense. But I don't know how it stays warm overnight. I don't know that it would, but I don't know. Here I am, safe and sound in my clean, freshly showered state. And yeah, thank you for listening, and I will let you know about my next farming adventure and what happens. I mean, I feel like after I get done farming, I need to take a shower, but apparently no one else did because they have solar showers, and I don't blame them because it was cold. So thanks for watching. Keep an eye on what happens next on this channel. We will see, and see you soon. Thanks. Bye.